Hello. Good evening. I'm good afternoon, everyone.
Afternoon.
Good evening. Can you hear me at the back?
Yes.
Yes. Is it too loud?
Yeah, that's okay.
Camera. Okay, good afternoon once again, brothers and sisters. Did you want to keep it back? Good afternoon again, brothers and sisters. So today, this month, it's our theme for this month is prayer, Proverbs, the word in the Bible. So I pick up as a topic for today, a book of the Bible. So in this topic, brothers and sisters, we will discuss about one person who was tested by God. So have you ever been angry? Can you raise your hand? Amen. Have you been confused?
Amen.
Amen. Have you been frustrated? Amen. So don't raise your hand. Have you been angry at God? So yeah. So in this book that we study, brothers and sisters, this is a test for one person how he was tested by God, yet he remains faithful. That's why if you see your bulletin today, it's about the story of Job, how he remained faithful in all circumstances. Because you know it's easy for us to be faithful when we are where everything is fine, right? Madaling mag-thank you when everything is fine, nothing is wrong with us. It's easy, but you know, as people said, you know, the test of the character of a person is when you are challenged, you are stuck in a struggle, right? But yung maganda yung bayan, it's not the real you, but you will know yourself once you are tested, when you are on a difficult situation, diba? Because it's easy to say you're good and emotionally you are fine, but how about if there's something wrong with you, something happened, you can get angry, you can blame people, you can be mad, right? And maybe you can question God, Lord, why is this happening, right? So today, brothers and sisters, we will study the book of Job. So if you have your Bibles, it should be in the middle of your Bible before the book of Psalms. So we will study the whole book. So please along. So we will take a while since this is longer than Brother Adams. So when we started, I said, oh, it's late, we will not have enough time. So we'll see, maybe we'll just do a series. But you know, my goal is to give the overall picture of the book and how about the life of Job and the conclusion of his life. So brothers and sisters, this is a very long verse if you read all of them, right? But I'll just pick one verse that will, somehow get the conclusion of everything. If you open your Bible to Job chapter 42, verse 10. Let's all stand. So this is only one verse, because there's too many verses, right? So maybe later after this short sermon, you can read the book of Job yourself and see the story. Job chapter 42, verse 10. After Job has prayed for his friends. The Lord restored his fortunes and gave him twice as much as he had before. Let us pray. Lord, thank you once again for this wonderful afternoon you have given us. We can come together to praise you and worship you, Lord, and to study your word. Give us your wisdom and understanding as we study your word so that we can learn the lessons you want us to know, O Lord. And that your name be glorified. Amen. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's all be seated. So, brothers and sisters, what we will do is we make a story of the whole book. So we'll go to Job chapter 1. So according to the Bible, Job is he lives in a place called Oz. It's not Oz in the movie, this one is Oz. So the Bible said he's a righteous man. Mm-hmm. He do things that is pleasing to God. And that he had sons and daughters, so he had 10 children. And he had acquired a lot of properties. Actually, he owns sheep and oxen and camels by the thousands. So, kumbaga sa atin is siya yung hasyendero, di ba? He has a lot of animals. Because back then, it's not you don't own a barn, you own property. You own big land and animals. So that shows how rich you are. So according to the Bible, he's the greatest man among the people of the East. He's one of the richest. So from these first few verses, brothers and sisters, we can say that, you know, some people say that, you know, you have to be poor to be good with God, to be pleasing to God. But you see here, brothers and sisters, Job, he was blessed by God, but he is pleasing to God. So it's not always, you know, that because you have to be poor so that God will be, you know, will be pleasing to God. But here is an example, right? Brothers and sisters, he had servants. He had big plots of lands, properties, but yet he do things that is pleasing to God, and he was blessed. So sometimes, you know, he is a family man, and sometimes his kids will go have a party. You know, I remember back when I went home, I and my siblings will go to one of the house of my sisters or brothers in the room. Come together and eat and have fun. So in the same here, his children does that too. Right? One time they go to their eldest son and they celebrate. They fish, they eat, and they drink. And you know, Job is a family man. He cares so much of his kids that you know what? Maybe my kids did something wrong. You know, even if not sure whether their kids did wrong or not, he will sacrifice a burnt offering for his kids, for his 10 children. So, baka itong anak ko, nagkasala sa Panginoon, iyano ko siya. I will make a sacrifice for him. So we see here how faithful Job was. He's a family man. He takes care of his family really well. That's why, and also at the same time, in a different place, there is God and his angels. And, they also talk once in a while. And here we see that, and that same time, while the Lord is talking to his angels, there also Satan came in. And then God said, "No, where have you been? Oh, I've been roaming here and there in the earth." So brothers and sisters, so what does it mean that, you know, the evil one is here? It could be anywhere, right? And then you know when somebody is so good with God, sometimes God will brag on him. Yung di ba yung just like even in the family, right? I remember my dad used to brag on him. So here God is bragging on Job because yung napakabuti ano niya, yung sumusunod sa Panginoon. He's pleasing to God. That's why God said, you know, have you considered my servant Job? So we said that usap na yung Panginoon binabar tayo. So just like here in the church. So is there something in you that God could brag about? Yung pwede pagmalaki ng Panginoon. Meron ba tayo as Christians? So it's a challenge to us brothers and sisters that, you know, as Christians go, we have something that God can be proud, right? Aside from us accepting the Lord in our heart, what is in you that God can be proud of? Are you honest? Do you help other people when they are in need? Do you serve God? So all those kinds of things. But you know, Satan challenged God and said, you know what? You know the reason why he is praising you and he's fearful of this because you protected him. You have the hands of protection on him. Everything that he does, you bless. So that's why you have all these things in his life. And you know, why would you take it away from him and see what he does? The moment you take it away, he will curse you to your face. So that was the challenge of Satan. And if you think about it, he's right, right? Right. It happens to people sometimes when they're in good, their life is good, they're good, and then when something wrong, they get cold. And then they question God. And so God said, you know what? Do whatever you want, but don't touch the man. Don't do anything to him. So what's the message, brothers and sisters, that you know there's nothing that will do to you will happen to you unless God allows it, right? Mm-hmm. So could it be that you are here because somewhere somehow God has protected you? I remember even in my own life, I could have not survived. It's only the God's protection that I survived. Kasi nung lakas kasi ako magmotor. And if I remember now how fast I drove, I know there's a lot of